Associate professor at Florida State University, but this semester, spring of 2018, I'm a visiting fellow at the Center for Philosophy of Science. So my interests are in kind of three distinct areas. One is philosophy of biology, the other one is history of analytic philosophy, and the other is environmental philosophy. Environmental philosophy, I mostly focus on philosophy of the environmental sciences. In history of analytic, I focus on this guy's work and his friends, the logical empiricists. And then in philosophy of biology, thus far my work is focused mostly on philosophy of ecology, philosophy of conservation biology. So at the center, I'll be working on two projects, both within philosophy of biology. So the first is a book on the philosophy of ecology. So you may be thinking, why ecology? Most philosophers of biology focus on evolutionary biology and molecular biology. Dobchansky said that nothing in biology makes sense except in the light of evolution, but that was pretty grievously partial, because at least the same could be said about ecology. Ecology, as another biologist put it, G. Hutchinson, there's an ecological theater and an evolutionary play. So a lot of the concepts in evolutionary biology, you really only get full traction on those concepts once you have an ecological perspective, like adaptation, the fit between an organism and its environment. So that's the first project. What are some of the issues in philosophy of ecology? There's many. For example, it's often tossed around the idea that there's a, quote, balance of nature. Things are sort of fit together and relatively homeostatic in the natural world. And pinning down exactly what that concept is, maybe cashing it out as some kind of stability concept, is pretty difficult. It turns out that there's many different things that are meant by a balance of nature, distinct conceptually. It's also the case that many times ecologists employ methodologies and concepts from different sciences, like physics, because a lot of modeling is done in ecology. And it's not always clear that that extraction from one science to another is defensible. Now, what's another? So what is biodiversity? That's a hot topic. And it's not entirely clear how to make that concept scientifically tractable. So diversity, all levels of biological generality, that's extremely general and not very scientifically useful. So it seems like you've got to, in some way, narrow the content of that concept if you want to use it in science. And some have argued that the only way to do that effectively is to employ non-epistemic values. So ethical values, what you care about, should be guiding you in how you delineate what you're going to take to be the biodiversity of a given natural system. There's many others. The second project that I'm working on here at the center is titled Semantic Information in a Biological World. And so this takes the kind of work done originally by Brian Skirms, his students, and many now collaborators, trying to show how signaling game dynamics can generate information that can have all the semantic characterizations that we think of when we think of natural language. So you can actually go from something that's unintelligent, something that may just be a bacterium and show that through this kind of modeling dynamics, that information with a strong semantic character can actually emerge. And so this project is attempting to show how you can take this modeling strategy and apply it actually intra-organism and intergenerationally. So I think that you can give a fully adequate characterization of biological information, a concept that a lot of philosophers of biology have floundered on for a long time, by employing some of the resources from this modeling strategy. I'd like to tell you more, especially about the work of this guy, but that would require another 5 minutes. Thanks.